I spoke with Matteo Scarlino by phone through an interpreter. He's been following the investigation. The question plaguing so many, was this a horrible accident or could foul play have been involved? He says Italian police are notoriously tight-lipped, but that autopsy and toxicology test results that are due soon could help provide some answers. His was a life full of love and laughter, just some of the many ways friends describe John Durkin, a 21-year-old student-athlete from Rye, studying abroad in Rome, the economics major out with friends last Wednesday night, those friends who would be the last to see him. Working with a reporter from the Italian newspaper Roma Today, we were able to compile this timeline. Friends left Durkin at 1:30 Thursday morning at Sloppy Sam's, a popular restaurant in the center of Rome that closed at 2 a.m. A little while later, a man was seen in surveillance video at San Pietro train station, walking alone on the tracks. That's 2.5 miles from the bar, and investigators are 99% sure the man was Durkin. Trains stopped running hours before at 11:30 p.m. and didn't start again until after 5 a.m. It was around 6:30 a.m. that a train passenger spotted a body inside a tunnel, located another 3 miles from San Pietro station. The victim did not have any ID. That same day, John Durkin was reported missing. The connection between his disappearance and the man in the train tunnel wasn't made for another day. His father arrived in Italy and identified his son's body. He's quoted by Italian press saying, "We want the whole truth." The reporter we spoke with through an interpreter says police seem to be focusing on a couple of things.
They're trying to piece that together of why he didn't have his identification on him and why he walked 3 kilometers. He walked 3 kilometers, that's where he was hit.
He says the area is not considered high crime and the case is unusual.
I mean, they've had people like 37, 40 years old being hit by trains, but nothing like this. It's never happened there.
Again, those test results are due any time. It's hoped they'll help complete the investigation. John's father, Tim Durkin, will stay in Rome until he can return to Rye with his son. Reporting live in Portsmouth, Jennifer Crompton, WMUR News 9.